come, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give him a little round of applause. Let's make sure that we've got a pulse here in the audience. Come on, Samaritch, make some noise. So, Maserati, the boys in white, and let me just talk you through some of the players that are out there. In the number four here, to my left, that is Fabio Maia, the Swiss lad who has been playing so, so well. Great to see him back in the saddle here in his hometown in St. Moritz. Indeed, you make some noise. The man in the orange helmet there making his debut, that is Kutlay Yaprak, the man from Turkey. We expect huge goals from you today, my friend. And then, of course, we have the two very, very talented gentlemen from Argentina, Adrián Laplace Jr., playing off six goals and, like I say, turning champion, world champion back in 2017 with his team Argentina, Valentin Novillo Estrada. So, Team Maserati ready to get the ball rolling and to start scoring some nice, nice goals. And we're just waiting now for, well, I think the Badgers are ready. Maserati, please take your positions. Kutlay, please take your positions over on the left-hand side. Kutlay, take your team. You are the captain. Ja, du siehst gut aus. Bring deine Jungs bitte ins Tor. Dankeschön. Maserati, you can chat later. We've got place on polo now. The Maseratis are ready. The Palace are ready.
Come on.
Let's go, Maserati. Adrián, please, let's make some moves. Somebody speaks Spanish to them. Vamos. Preferably today, gentlemen. Okay, you're not getting invited to the after party. That's it, you've ruined it. Valentin, please make your move. Adrián, we're waiting for you. What does Rich always say? Send them a male, an email, a female, something, but just get the message over to them. Here we go then. Maseratis, please start your engines. Let's go.
Christian, kleiner Check, sagen, Kutlay 1, Fabio 4, Adrián 3 und Valentin 2. Nee, nee, Vergleich mit den Spielern jetzt.
Ja, wir vergleichen, aber Fabio wird wieder die 4 spielen.
Ja, Marc ist, aber das stimmt alles. Marc ist die 2, Melissa ist die 1, Roldan 3, das stimmt alles.
3 und die stimmt?
Ja, stimmt, stimmt.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to St. Moritz, welcome to the Snow Polo World Cup, welcome to the Engadine Valley, and welcome to Switzerland. We are proud to be Swiss, and we are very proud to have you here with us today. So please rise, we are going to play the Swiss national anthem. Thank you very much. And now, let's start with the polo. And I hand you over to the one and only voice of polo, Jan Erik Frank. They're all yours.
Thank you very much. Now, come on, St. Moritz, let's make some noise here. Give them a big round of applause. Play for the La Martina Trophy. And they are still the defending champions. And we have, of course, a lady on the field. So we're going to start from right to left. Please put your hands together for the Queen of Snow Polo. Ladies and gentlemen, from Florida, America, give it up for the one and only Melissa Ganzi. And as I said, this is a world first. A husband and wife playing together. Please welcome the Cobra, Mr. Mark Ganzi. With them in that team, America's number one top player. Ladies and gentlemen, 8 golder. There is only one man that can, and that is Mr. Nick Roldan. And at number four, ladies and gentlemen, the heartthrob that is Alejandro Novillo Estrada. And now over to the four gentlemen in the white shirts playing for Maserati. At number one, also making his debut here in St. Moritz. A great polo player, a gentleman both on and off the field. My dear friend, give it up for the Turkish player called Kutlay Yaprak. At number two, playing against his cousin, this is Valentin Novillo Estrada. At number four, the man who always has a smile on his face. Give it up for the very handsome Adrian Leplaset. Und jetzt bitte ein ganz, ganz besonderen Applaus. Der einzigste junge Schweizer auf dem Platz. Give it up for Fabio Meyer. Your umpires this afternoon, mounted on the field, chief umpire Mr. Oliver Ellis and Mr. Charles Seville, and up here. Got an award yesterday, exactly, and very much deserves as well. And over here, up with us on the speaker's tower, the third man, Mr. Marcelo Garan. Thank you very much to our friends from Maserati, leading in the teams. Lady and gentlemen, please line up. Remember, they're playing for the La Martina Trophy, and we will have, of course, that presentation on the podium right after this game. St. Moritz, are you ready? Well, let's play some polo. Ball's thrown into play. Now, who's going to get the first touch? Oh, look at him. There he comes. That is the man with the number three on his back. The cousin playing against, of course, his cousin, Valentin Novillo Estrada, with the number two. Look at him go. Not wasting any time. Getting straight into fifth gear here for Team Maserati. Now, just to explain to you once again, if you are newcomers to the world of polo, every player has a handicap. The handicaps of all 14 players are added together, and that number should, of course, be equal on both sides. If that isn't the case, as is here the case, Maserati, on paper at least, and that's just theoretically slightly weaker. They were given 2.5 goals advantage, and you can see they're not wasting any time, and this could be Fabio Meyer. Meyer! He's up against the 8-goaler, Nick Roldan, und der lässt da bestimmt nichts anbrennen. Man muss natürlich aufpassen, denn der Charme eines Schweizers, da schmilzt auch jeder Schnee und jedes Eis. Meyer needs to be very careful here. And there's a nice little pass up to the front, a little bit short. It was intended for Melissa Ganzi. Maserati clearly wanting to win the La Martina Trophy and come third overall. Being pushed deep into their own half. Novillo Estrada has a lot of traffic behind him, but he's got the support. Meyer working very, very hard. And a nice little under the neck. Now then, is he going to get to it? Roldan will try and pick this one up. He won't quite reach it. There's the open backhand. Tries to clear it, take it out of the danger zone. Didn't really get enough power on that shot. Here we go, the Nick Roldan show. Outside he goes, Roldan. Watch him take the shot to goal! Elegance in motion there. by the young American who, just in case you didn't know, actually has a German mum. Indeed. And that makes it 1-3.5. So the Palace not wasting any time either. They want to give Maserati a really good run for their money. Ball's back in play. Picked up by Kutlay Yaprak, the captain, in the orange helmet. Feeds it up to Fabio Maier. Maier, look at him go. Maier, the pony, needs to get there before Alejandro Nevejo Estrada has to ruin it for him. But a nice little play there from Fabio Maier. Now remember, don't hold back. We are not in church here. You can make as much noise as you wish. Ball's in play. The Palace. Alejandro Nevejo Estrada. There's the pass. Looking for Roldan. And as you can probably work out, it's all about pony power. All of these players, very, very talented. Left behind now for La Placette. He's got a bit of traffic. He's got to be careful here because Alejandro will not be needing to be asked twice to take that ball. In comes Roldan. He wants a piece of the action. Still Roldan. An appeal to the umpire, and the Palace come out on top. Alejandro needs to get the ball, or he tries to get it on his stick side. A little flick of the wrist there, looking to send it back up to the front door, and this could be a possible counter-offensive attack here for Maserati. Nicely done, it's lofted over all the players. Kutlay reaching out into the skies to try and pick that ball out as he does. Roldan, he's got Fabio Maier. Now the tables are turned. Maier will try and challenge the eight-goaler. Look at him take it. Playing cat and mouse here with Maserati. Still Nick Roldan. But he's got one too many Maserati defenders, making life very difficult for him. Ball is still just in play. Goes into no man's land. Who's going to pick it up? What's he going to do? A little near side. He has a little cheeky look over his shoulder. Again, the three on his shirt, the eight goals to his name, Nick Roldan. He's done this before. Will he hit the target again? It just goes wide. But I know that this great audience in St. Moritz will put their hands together. Half chucker, gentlemen, thank you very much. We're going to leave you with a little bit of music, and we'll be back with the second half of chucker number one in a few moments. Here we go then, thank you very much, DJ Mike. The players are back out on the field. And as we've been mentioning all weekend, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you see these beautifully turned out ponies, these talented polo players. But of course, the engine room of every polo team are, of course, the very, very high number of boys and girls looking after these ponies for 365 days a year. St. Moritz, please, a little bit of appreciation for the grooms turning out these wonderful ponies here for your entertainment. Thank you very much. So back to the action we go. 3.5-1. Once again, Maserati on the forefront. Oh, look at him, Maier. Look at that pony open up from Fabio Maier. The Cobra sends it back towards the 60-yard line. Luckily for Maserati, there was a man paying attention. Ball didn't quite make it to Melissa. Oh, cheeky little play. Now Melissa will take this one and run with it. Give her half a chance. Maserati being pushed back into their own half. Alejandro Nevejo Estrada looking to take on his cousin, Valentin. Here we go. Estrada versus Estrada. Oh, that's a nice little control here from Valentin. Valentin! Hits the post. In the ball is still in play as Valentin looking to send it up to Nick Roldan. It's a little bit short. Maserati on fire here this afternoon. Sends the ball back up to the front door. Maier. Fabio Maier takes the pace out. Clever little play there from the Swiss international polo player, but he couldn't quite finish what he had started. Just too many defenders. Oops, it's a daisy. That's a quote out of a movie. I'm sure you know which one. The umpires, and that is a really nice thing to see so far in this game. Very little as far as fouls are concerned. A very open and fast game, and above all, a very, very fair game. And which reminds me, I would like to also once again mention, and they've been part of our team for many, many years. We have Clinic Gut, our emergency response unit, right there. And then, of course, we also have Bethanien. So we have all the medical support we could possibly ever need. So thank you very much. And I know that when Clinic Gut need to come out on the field, they know before the player is injured, he needs to be seen to. We hope not to see that happen, but if we do, you'll see what I mean. Here we go, a hit from the spot for the Palace Hotel, who of course are still defending champions last year. The history books will tell you one day that the first lady player ever to win this tournament is on the field as we speak, Melissa Ganzi. Valentin tries to fish the ball out of the corner there. He's done well. Now then, how's he going to get round all those Maserati defenders? Oh, nicely done. Out of nothing. That's Chuck. And gentlemen, that is Chucker. Thank you very much. And now before we hand over back to DJ Mike, I'd like to welcome some very, very dear friends of ours from the Polo family who've come all the way from Perth in Australia. I did have the names written down somewhere here. I will find them, but in the meantime, I hope you enjoy a little bit of Akadaka! And this is for Nisia, Jason and Sophia. What's up, Nick? He's good, he's good. Thank you, Nick. And it's great to see that we've got fans from all corners of the world. A big thank you very much to our friends all the way from Australia making it to be with us here. Thank you very much. Great to have you with us. Here we go then. Yes, indeed. 2 to 3.5. We're about to start with Chucker number 2. The Palace ready. Maserati very much ready. Ball's thrown in play. Kutlai. Oops. You okay, Nick? Now watch this guy. Watch, here he comes. Cleanly good, Speedy Gonzalez. Yep, give him a round of applause. Nowhere in the world will you see a medic coming out so quickly.
Maui, our... This is Maui.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for the man on that sled, Mr. Maui! Been waiting all year to do that. You okay, Nick? Oh, well, that is a nice gesture there of Adrien Laplacette, making sure that his opponent with the number 3 is okay. Here we go, then on the far side, they're going to throw in the ball. A little bit of a quick turn on that play as the ball was thrown in. Here we go. Ball is back in play. Alejandro Navijo makes the ball trickle over the back line. Nice little backhander there from the captain, Kutlai Yaprak, hoping to find his number 3. Adrien Laplacette, Alejandro Navijo is trying to knock someone over the sideboards. Ladies and gentlemen, if you do end up having a ball coming near you, you can either catch it or watch it drop, but please do not throw it back into the arena. We have plenty of balls to play with. Here we go then, balls back in play. A little bit of a traffic jam there on the halfway line. Everybody wants it. Everybody wants a piece of the action. That's what it looks like when you have 8 alpha males and 1 alpha female on the field. They all want a piece of it. And now then, here we go. All of a sudden, look at him. Nick rolled down. That's what he does so well. Well, he tried to cut that a little bit too fine. Tried to make some Buettner flash out of that shot. But the ball didn't quite hit the end of his mallet. Alejandro. Yeah, a real man would have caught that. Never mind. So we're going to have another throw in on the far side. Now, let me just very gently and carefully ask you here just to gauge, because I'm not really feeling a pulse at the moment. Who would like to see the defending champions, the Badgers Palace Hotel, win this La Martina trophy? It's about 6 of you. Nice to have you with us. Now, what about the team in white, Maserati? Who would like to see them win the La Martina trophy? Yeah, it's very even. It's another about 7 or 8 of you, but never mind. We'll get you going as the sun comes out. Here we go, back to the action then. Alejandro takes it round. He's got the Cobra clearing his way, and all of a sudden, cheeky little play there from Adrian Laplacette. Laplacette couldn't finish what he started. Oh, nicely done by Valentin, tries to control it on the 30-yard line. Valentin, cheeky little number there with a flick of the wrist. He's got a bit of traffic, appealing, and that's rightly so. The umpire saw that there was a block in front of his right of way. Now then, let's wait and see. They'll either give him a hit from the spot or a penalty 2. The penalty 2 is that blue line, the first coming across the field. That's 30 yards distance, undefendable. I think they're going to go for the hit from the spot. Now, Sam Maritz, I would like to see or feel an eruption of applause as soon as this ball goes over the back line. Wait for it. Here comes the captain, Kutla Yaprak. Here we go. Well, he'll understand what I mean. He has now scored 8 goals in this tournament. 1 on Friday, 1 yesterday, and now his 3rd goal here today in this final for 3rd and 4th place, as you know, playing for the La Martina Trophy. Roldan, look at that goal, ladies and gentlemen, from Nick Roldan. And I can assure you, there are very, very few people in the world who can do exactly that. Nick, of course, is one of them. I'm another. And Reto is the third. We're the only 3 who can do that. What? Am I lying? It's half chucker, gentlemen. Half chucker. Go and change your ponies.
I did it without the horse. Different guy in there. Was die Idee ist, ist klar, was zu machen. Aber das ist das Problem. Wenn der Ball dann drüben rausgeht, geht.
Ach so. Ach so, okay.
So another quick pony change. Here we go. Half a chucker play. We're in the second chucker and it's very, very close. The Palace gaining momentum and gaining scores. It is 3 to 4.5. Maserati still in the driving seat here, leading at the moment in this match. Two of the players going up, waiting for that ball to come. Remember, after every chucker, they change ends. Maserati being pushed deep into their own half. The Palace would like to get within half a goal of Maserati, and Maserati, you've done a great job in clearing that little situation. And now then the Cobra tries to send it back. Here we go, Fabio Mayer. Come on, Fabio. Oh, he did well, the Cobra. It has a deflection. Kutlay, Kutlay, that had your name written all over it. Picked up again by Nick Roldan. Roldan on the far side. Leaves it behind. Alejandro sends it back up. There was a deflection. Now then, can he turn? Fabio Mayer tries to pick it up. Beg your pardon, that wasn't Mayer. That was Adrian Laplacette. But Kutlay sends it back to his number three and had an unfortunate deflection. And Alejandro will be thinking, thank God for that, as he takes the ball up towards and over, well, nearly the halfway line. It's sent back again. Who can turn first? A lot of time here to regroup, as Nick Roldan has a lot of space and a lot of time. No one coming in to challenge. You'll be looking up who to play it to. Melissa is already over the halfway line. It's going to drop exactly how and where she wants it. Come on, Melissa. Solid first touch from her. Melissa Ganzi. Oh, come on, Melissa. Well, that did look very, very close, as Alejandro, he might come in and finish it. Alejandro runs into a little bit of traffic, but either way, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause. Great play there by Melissa Ganzi. Well, that goal was definitely hanging in the air, and I think she had a little bit of obstruction. She won't be happy with that. It definitely had her name written all over it. A little bit of a conversation going on there, but it's going to be a hit from the spot, it looks like, at least in favor of the whites team Maserati, who are deep in their own half. You can see the Palace pressing, don't want them to allow them to open up their play, want to stop them in their tracks. Here comes the shot. That's a nice little targeted shot, as he finds Adriancito Laplacette. In comes Valentin. Still Laplacette, he's going to run this one across the field, looking for Kutlay Yaprak, and he's going to give way to Fabio Mayer. The Swiss gentleman, Mayer! Trying to send it over all the defenders from the Palace. Now this could be a very quick break here for Alejandro. Yeah, as I said, a real man would have caught that. So we're going to have another throw in, and I'm just going to look at the timekeeper. How are we doing for time? A minute to go, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. 1 minute to play in the first half. Ball's back on the field. And it is so important to try and win that throw in. That immediately puts you in the offensive mode. Team who have to concede that throw in, of course, straight away on their back foot. Nicely taken. And again, picture-perfect passes here from Maserati. Perfect precision play here. Now they're round the outside. We have a two-man horse race. Here he goes. Look at him go. Adrian Laplacette on the near side. Beautifully taken there. He timed it just right. Adriancito Laplacette, he got a little bit lucky there. Came off the inside of that left-hand post. But a score's a score, and Maserati will be happy. There's the bell. They'll be taking a nice little cushion of advantage into the halftime break. The Palace, I'm sure, will be discussing tactics and strategy of how to come back and break this very solid performing team Maserati, who so far doing everything right. Great also performance from the captain Kutlay Yaprak, teeing up some very nice shots here for his attacking players. And again, Maserati on the attack here. A little under the next shot, didn't quite make the connection. Gentlemen, that is Jacques Samaritz. Please make some noise for the Palace Hotel and team Maserati.
Who is in charge of the whole infrastructure.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to also, who I haven't mentioned yet, come and have a look up here at the Tower of Power. Dorigo Perorini, the man who is responsible, and his team, for providing you with this perfect surface to play on. Give it up for Dorigo! Boys and girls, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back, and a warm welcome if you've only just joined us. We've already had two thrilling chuckers here playing for the La Martina Trophy. They've just gone and changed ponies. We are the top of chucker number three, and a whistle will stop the players in their tracks early on. Player there having lost his mallet. So they're probably going to have another throw in. Let's wait and see what the umpires decide. Remember, the two mounted umpires, chief umpire who won the award yesterday, you should really call it a lifetime award, Oliver Ellis, having won this himself, formerly a six goaler, won the British Open, played all over the world, and now for over 20 years, an HPA umpire, would not be the same without him. With him on the field, Charles Seville, and up here, the third man, Marcelo Garahan. So the foul has been given. There was a foul against Maserati. It's going to be hit from the spot for the Palace Hotel. And it'll be taken very quickly by Alejandro Navija Estrada. Now then, they need three. Oh, cheeky little play. Now here we go. They turn it around. Adrian Laplace, he's got Nick Roldan coming in for the challenge. Here's the long distance shot. So close, so close. He knew he had no choice because Nick Roldan will have challenged him. He will have come in for the ride off. Remember, you can ride a player off that imaginary line, that line, the right of way, which cannot be crossed. Let me just explain that to you again. Once a player hits a ball, the line that that ball takes and the continuation of that line is the automatic right of way. You cannot cross that unless there is a significant distance between you and that player coming down the line, all down, of course, to pony welfare. Kutlay Aprak, solid little backhander. But Alejandro tried to make a chorri pan out of that one, but it goes wide. So Maserati will be happy that he just put it wide, and they have possession. Play is called. Clock keeps ticking. Remember, we play four chuckers of actual play time. A duration of a chucker is 6 minutes. Once the clock, or once the whistle blows, the clock will stop, and after 6 minutes you will hear that bell, which indicates and tells the players there are 30 seconds left to play. Should a whistle be blown during those 30 seconds, that will automatically conclude that chucker. And again, power play here from the Palace this time. Putting it out to the left-hand side. Maserati once again at the moment, struggling to get out of their own half. As the ball is tapped back into play. Couple little taps, those are the little shots. He's got Kutlay out to his left. In comes a challenge from Melissa. But Nevija Estrada doing well, but he might just be up against one too many defenders. Roldan trying to ride him off that line. A little cheeky backhand as he feeds the ball up. Now waiting is Fabio Maier and the captain. It comes off the pony of the Cobra. But in comes once again Adrian Laplacette. Just robbed by Alejandro Nevija Estrada. Waits for the rebound off the sideboards. Little quick turn there, Maier. But beating them to it there is the Cobra. Now the Cobra must keep that ball in play. Cheeky and a dangerous play right in front of his goal mouth. Picked up again nicely by Nevija Estrada. There comes the big hammer. Tries to send it back on the near side. This is perfect polo displayed here, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, Sam Moritz. I can't feel a pulse. Make some noise here. Nicely taken. Flat out by the Cobra. In comes Melissa, she's just hovering, that could be her line. And as I thought, well, there's a lot of discussion going out on the field. We'll have to wait and see what the umpire's made out of that. To me, it looked like Melissa had obtained that line, but of course, I'm not the umpire. We'll have to wait and see what they decide. I'm usually right. And indeed, this is what I thought would be the case. So the Palace Hotel, been awarded a penalty to 30 yards, and I have a hunch it's going to be taken by Melissa herself. Gets her pony into a nice calm canter. Well, it was a good strike. And that, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, is half chucker. Thank you very much, gentlemen. It's half chucker. If you feel so, change your ponies. We'll be back after a few tunes here from DJ Mike. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I've got a very, very anxious and nervous man here, the chief executive of Europe for Maserati, Amaury. Would you like to say a few words maybe to spur on your team out there?
Well, thanks, Eric. I'm not so anxious. I have full trust and confidence in the Maserati team. And they have great supporters here. So everybody who wants to support us, you can just shout, Forza Maserati! And I mean, it's a perfect occasion here to present our very new model, the Royal Limited Edition in Levante and Quattroporte. Please come and have a look. And if you want to take a test drive, we also have the full lineup for you ready.
Wonderful. Those are the two words, Forza Maserati. Can anybody say that? Everybody, can we say Forza Maserati? Yeah, great. You're a great audience. You're a great audience. Brilliant. And we'll say the same for the Palace. Forza, Baduz Palace! You are a great audience. The rumours are true. So here we go then. They're lining up and it's going to be a Maserati who have possession. I think we're just waiting, is it, for one more player to join his teammates. There he is with the number three, Nick Roldan, who gave us that superb goal a little bit earlier on in that second chucker. He had a little tumble, but he's okay. I spoke to him before the tournament, after the practice game on Thursday. He's absolutely loving it here in St Moritz. And I'm sure we will see some more great action from him throughout the end of this third chucker. Remember, there's a fourth chucker to come, and that's a nice little pass. Now, I, of course, have got my eyes on that man with the number four, Fabio Maier. Maier, they've left it behind. Nice little open backhand, but there's nobody home for Maserati to pick up that ball. Instead, it is once again, and he's got a very, very busy day at the office here. Alejandro Nevija Estrada, the Cobra, drills the ball over the halfway line. He might have another tap at that one. In comes the challenge. Oh, that was a little bit too cheeky, a bit too aggressive maybe for the eyes of the umpires, hence the whistle. They've stopped play. Christian, I'm sure, will tell me how much time is left in this chukka. 3 minutes, guys and girls, 3 minutes left to play in chukka number three. And of course, as I mentioned earlier, please join us over on the podium right after this game for the presentation of the La Martina Trophy. La Martina, of course, and delighted to have them with us this year again, our official merchandise partners. A stand on the lake where you can pick up any of the team shirts, all, of course, made by our friends from La Martina. And I'm hoping you all had a good time last night in the Stefani Hotel, the La Martina Snow Polo Party. As we go back to the action, Roldan looking for a little gap between that Maserati defense, and they've done well. Maier, great touch there on the near side in front of his own goal mouth, but the pressure is still on as Nick Roldan tries to find a little space for himself. He gets the support there from his number two, the Cobra, Mark Ganzi. He's lending a little bit of a helping hand there. Oh, he came out of the saddle far. Great shot if he got that one as he came out and tried to hit the ball under the neck of his pony. Alejandro Nevija Estrada, Laplace just avoiding the challenge that came in there from Roldan. Now then a chance here for Maserati to break and take it all the way up the field. Good run here. That is the man with the number three, Adrian Laplace. Laplace just waltzing Matilda through that Badru's Palace defense, as if he was taking the dog for a stroll on the lake. Kutlai, he puts his oar in, but again, it all ends up at the feet and at the mallet there of Alejandro Nevija Estrada. Nice little play, and now this could be the break we've been waiting for. Here we go, Adrian Laplace. Keep your cool, my friend. Oh, oh, but a round of applause nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen. Put your hands together. Great little play there from Adrian Laplace. Well, there is definitely a few more goals looming in the air, I know that for sure, as the Palace will get things underway again. A shot over across his goal, but Maserati now also very deep in the Palace territory in their back garden. Nick Roldan, he's got a man on, and this young kid really playing out of this world. Fabio Maier impressed me no end yesterday and the day before, but look at that run on the far side from Nick Roldan. Nicely taken, there's a man already turning, he's looking and waiting for the ball to come. Valentina Vizier Estrada, here comes the pass, I think it had his name on it. Fabio Maier, he's gonna get beaten to it again by Alejandro Nevija Estrada, and he saw already turning Nick Roldan. He's got eyes in the back of his head here, but at the moment it is all down to Maserati, who have got the pressure on the Palace. Nicely taken out of the play there. Now though, we're gonna see a long distance shot. We've heard the bell. Still the right of way applies. He's trying to open his shoulder. Stop teasing us. There's the shot. Kutlai. Little backhand, and he crossed the line, ladies and gentlemen, and that will be end of chukka number three. The lovely people of St. Moritz, please put your hands together and make some noise.
Center that a bit more into the middle. next year I'm building grandstands like this, so it doesn't even matter. But the only reason I didn't put it in the middle is because with that tent, in order to put it next to it, you can't see it.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm delighted to welcome onto the microphone now a very dear friend of mine, a very talented polo player, and not only that, one of your very own from the Engadine. He's going to talk you through to the fourth of this very, very entertaining match indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the local lad that is Mr. Tito Gaudenzi.
Thank you, Jan-Erik. Please also a big round of applause. Jan-Erik Frank has done a great job all weekend. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Sunday. We can do a little more energy. Who wants to see Budgets Palace win today? Who wants to see Team Maserati win today? And who just wants to see great polo? Fantastic. So, we have here start of the fourth chucker. We have a center hit in favor of Team Maserati in white. Oh no, sorry. For Budrus Palace. Let's see. The ball lays dead center. It will be a spot hit from the center for Team Budrus Palace, the winners, of course, of last year. And you see Alejandro Novillo Estrada, the number four, on a beautiful mare by the name of Top Model. Had a fantastic game in Kitzbühel last week. Passed it there to Nick. Picked up there now by Novillo Estrada. Sorry, Adrian Laprasette. Back shot there. Deflected. Picked up there by the Cobra, by Ganzi. Ganzi loses the ball. In comes one Novillo Estrada, two Novillo Estradas. Well, oh, what a steal there by Nick Roldan. Now can he has Melissa Ganzi all alone in the front. There comes a long pass. It deflects. Still there on the number four. There comes Alejandro Novillo. Nick, no goal. What a play there. Good defense there by Team Maserati in white. The ball is out of play. Looks like we will have a hit in favor of Team Maserati. So play is called. Hit in there. Maserati with a long lofted ball for the team captain, but the ball is out of play, and we will have a throw-in from the center of the field. So, one more chucker to go. Everything up for grabs. There comes, under the next shot there, picked up there by Kutlai, the team captain, misses the ball, picked up there now by Ganzi leaves it for Novillo Estrada. Novillo Estrada, the ball deflects. In comes Ganzi with a beautiful pass there for Novillo Estrada. No goal. What a shot there. Ein applaus bitte, meine Damen und Herren. What an approach there by Mark Ganzi, also known as the Cobra. So, another hit in. Obviously, this is valuable time that Team Budrus Palace is losing in order to make up. They have to score three goals to win this. We have a broken stick. So we stop time. So in comes, Alejandro, different team, Valentino Villo Estrada. I believe he's riding Pantera, which was best playing pony last year here, both winter and summer, and best playing pony also in Kitzbühel last year. Fantastic mare. So, now we have hidden there. It will be taken by the number two, by Valentin Novillo Estrada. Play is called, ball is back in play there for Team Maserati. Team Maserati looks, searches, finds, defending player. Back there by Roldan, looking for his number one. Melissa Ganzi in comes. Alejandro, we just saw the back shot there by Valentin. What a shot, Ken, picked up there by Meyer. Meyer, but there is Meyer. Can he go? Can he make it happen? Followed there, chased by Nick Roldan. Still Meyer on the near side. Look at that, once, twice in the air. Is this gonna be all the way? What a goal, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, couldn't have done it any better. Look at that by Fabio Meyer. I'm looking forward and playing with him this summer for the Swiss national team. What a young player. Verni, did you teach him that? Can you teach me tomorrow? Thank you. Okay, ball is back in play, picked up there now by, well, it looks like Valentino Vigiostrada. In comes Alejandro Vigiostrada on the near side. There comes, what a nice near side shot, but in comes the Cobra with the back shot, deflects, can't get it. Back shot there now for the number three, Nick, but in defense is Fabio Meyer. He can't get it. Now we have Nick. Nick taking his time, tapping the ball once, twice, centering towards goal. What a defensive play there by Fabio. What a game. Half chucker, medio chucker. So,
e deve chiamare qualcuno della security se fa spostare la gente, perché hanno rotto la corda di plastica, si appoggiano tutti qua alla barriera e non vedo più niente.
Ladies and gentlemen, we get into the last half of the last chucker. So one more time, I will ask you, who wants to see the leading team right now at 6.5 goals? Team Maserati to win! And who wants to see the defending champion catch up and win? Badruz Palace! And who's having a good time? Okay, at least we agree on everything. So, we will have a hit in there now in favor for Team Maserati, obviously leading by 3.5 goals. Badruz Palace would have to score 4 goals, but it is possible. There's roughly 2.5, 3 minutes left to play. Christian, 3 minutes, so it is possible, but it's also very difficult. But let's see what happens. Now comes a hit in there by Valentin Novigio-Astrada. Valen takes his time now, looking for the long shot, the flex there on Nick Roldan. Nick Roldan now on the line, picks up the ball, takes it front, back shot there. Oh, look at Valentin. Horse picked itself up. There comes Melissa Ganzi on the near side. Once, twice, three times, four times, and no goal. Back shot there by Meyer, but there comes Alejandro Novigio Astrada. What a goal. Meine Damen und Herren, ein bisschen Applaus bitte. At a whistle. Teams lining up now with 4 goals to 6.5. Can Badruz Palace come back? Back shot there by Melissa, picked up there now by Roldan. Roldan. Still Roldan. He's looking for the long shot there for Alejandro Vigiostrada. Alejandro, can he do it again? Yes, ladies and gentlemen. So, 5 goals to 6.5. Badruth Palace needs two more goals to win this match. Can they make it happen? 1.5 minutes. And I will give over to the host with the most, obviously Jan-Erik Frank, the voice of Polo, for the last 1.5 minutes of Polo.
Thank you very much. Let's make some noise for your very own Mr. Tito Gaudenzi. Thank you, Tito. Gave me a chance to catch my breath, and what a thrilling match we are seeing here this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Unfortunately, there always has to be a winner and a runner-up, but I think you'll agree with me. They are both worthy, worthy finalists here playing for the third and fourth place, the La Martina Trophy, which reminds me, please come and join us afterwards on the podium for the presentation of that La Martina Trophy. Now, I can also tell you, due to the beautiful weather that we're having, we will be starting the main final this afternoon a little bit later than expected. So time for you to have a little stroll through the Trade Village. Have a look and see if you can maybe pick up a nice little souvenir for those who didn't make it to the 36th edition of the Snow Polo World Cup here in St Moritz. 2:30 will be the throw-in of the big final, so make sure you join us in time. Secure yourself a nice little seat. But now let's go back to the action and watch this man who all of a sudden is on fire for the Palace Hotel. Behind him is Nick Roldan. The ball got defended, but I think I heard a whistle. Let's see what the umpires make of this. This could be the very, very important and crucial goal that is needed by the Palace to at least get to number 6 on the score sheet. Then that's half a goal. It will be all that's in it. Let's wait and see what the umpires make of this. The atmosphere here is electrifying. Yeah, don't forget to breathe, everybody. Don't forget to breathe. Well, I think I was right in my assumption. It's going to go in favor of the Badruth Palace Hotel. And it really would be nice if Melissa got a chance to, well, I thought she was robbed a little bit earlier on. And I'm sure she would like to have a go at this. She's definitely got the nerves. She's definitely got the talent and the experience. That's why they call her the Queen of Snow Polo. Well, I think based on the way she's riding around, she's trying to get herself into the zone. The ball's just being teed up here now. Then let's give a little bit of quiet here for Melissa Ganzi. I thought that was in. I'm sorry, that looked very in to me, but it's just gone wide. And lucky. Let's give a round of applause. Great effort there by Melissa Ganzi. So they still need two quick goals. Maserati know the clock is running down. What are they going to do here? Are they going to try and score another one? This is all costing valuable time. There's the pass to Fabio May, who scored that impressive goal a few moments ago. Melissa turns. Valentin. Is he going to make a mistake? Is he going to be... Well, we had a whistle, I was just about to say. Is he going to lose his concentration? With Melissa coming down, wanting to steal that ball, but the whistle blew. And I have a feeling it's going to go in favor of Maserati. Christian, how much time is left? 25 seconds, guys, 25 seconds. You know the score, a lot can happen in 25 seconds. That's how they made my second brother. Here we go then. Ball's back in play. It's going to be picked up by Laplacette. And there's an appeal from Roldan. The ball up to the front. Kutlay Aprak, is he going to put the finishing touch to what has been a superb display of polo here? Oh, hang on, hang on. It's not over yet. And that is it, ladies and gentlemen. Please put your hands together. The winners of the La Martina Trophy, Forza Maserati! And if I could ask both teams, Kutlay, please, if you'd like to bring your team all the way around. The 25,864 spectators would like to show their appreciation. They're going to shake the obligatory hands. And then I would also wish and like Melissa to please bring her team round. St Moritz would like to say thank you and farewell. Kutlay and Melissa, please, can we have a ride by? Let's make some noise here. Here they come, the winners of the La Martina Trophy. Give it up for the young man from Switzerland, Fabio. And what a great picture, the two captains, Kutla Yaprak and Melissa Ganzi. Thank you, what a great display. Well done, Melissa. Thank you, Adrian Laplacette. Well played, Valentin. What a great picture, the two captains. Come on, Sabarets, make some noise. And here, the man who worked so hard, Valentin Novillo Estrada. And thank you also to Nick Roldan. Thank you also to the Cobra. Now join us, please, over at the podium for the presentation of the La Martina Trophy. See you momentarily.